Microsoft just launched a new feature that lets you add AI directly to your database with no code required. It's called Prompt Columns. Prompt Columns bring the power of AI Builder prompts natively inside of your Dataverse tables. With this feature, you can do things like data analysis, classification, and even content creation right in your Dataverse tables. So let's see how it works. First thing we need to do is go to the Dataverse table where we want to create a prompt column. Let's start with our support tickets table. This is where our team stores and manages our IT support tickets. So we have information like who reported it and what the issue is. Rather than letting our end users put in what they think the priority should be of this, we're going to leverage AI to do that for us based off of the issue description. This is a great use case for a prompt column. To create your prompt column, we'll select this plus button to add a new column into this table, and we'll give the column a name. This is going to be our priority column. And now we just need to change the data type. So if we choose this data type dropdown, we'll see a new option for a prompt data type. And this will show this button where we can add a new prompt. When you do this, it comes with a sample prompt that you may or may not want to use. I want to do something really specific, so I'm going to click on these three dots and clear out this prompt that it comes with. Now you'll notice this right here we can't change. This is the system instructions for the prompt, letting it know that this is for creating a prompt column. But we can add our own custom instructions below. We'll keep this one really simple. What I want to do with this prompt is have it analyze the issue description and then classify the priority level based off of that description, whether it's critical, high, medium, or low. Now to make this prompt work and have it actually get the data from our table, we need to map it to where that data is stored. So I'm going to replace where I have the issue description, and I'll select this add content button. This will point me to the Dataverse table that I'm in, and I can click that and see all the columns in that table. And I'll map it to the issue description. We'll add that, and now our prompt is all wired up. Now before we use this, we can run a quick test to make sure that it's going to return the results that we want. I'll click this test button, and we'll see what it does. And when we do this test, it's going to run through a few of the items in the list to show us what the result would be. So in this case of a security issue, it's going to mark that as critical. And if we look at this performance degradation, that is a medium. So we'll get a good idea of if this is working how we expect it. Now, one thing I can do to tweak this prompt and make sure that it's not adding anything other than what I need is I can simply add at the end, do not include anything except the priority level. So if I feel good about this prompt, now I can save it. And that saves the prompt itself. And now we click save one more time to save the actual prompt column. Now, one thing that you'll notice after I save this column is the data that we have in here is blank. So when you create a prompt column, if you're creating it inside of a table that already has existing data, this isn't going to go through and be able to run this for existing data. This is only for new items. So now when we add any new data into this table, it's going to automatically populate that priority column for us. Now, if I did have existing data that I wanted this to apply to, I would need to go and create this prompt inside of make.powerautomate.com, and then I could run a flow that would go through all the records, run the prompt, and then populate that column. Now, if I want to see this column working for new data added, I could, of course, go to a model-driven app where I'm using this, make sure that I add this new column into my views and forms, add a new item and test it out that way, or if I'm right here on the table already, I can just go to edit, and we'll add an item directly into the table to see what it does. I'll select new row, and I'll say blue screen of death, help. See if I use lots of exclamations, if it will make that actually make it critical. And what do you know? It looks like it did. It marked that as a critical issue, which it is, so that looks like that's working pretty well. If you want to trick the AI, we know the key now is lots of exclamation points. And these prompt columns are really helpful because in the past, if we wanted to do this, it required some overhead. We would have had to add in a workflow element to this to go through and check and monitor when a new item is added, go and call the prompt, and then update the item. Now that just all happens in real time, natively in your table. So let's look at another example of this. We can do more than classification with these prompts. We can also have it create text for us. So let's go into this project task table. And this is where I'm just storing some information about what the project is, the task details, any blockers, and the date. So our team, we have to go in and put in and update all of our projects for the week in here. And then our project manager goes through all of this and she'll put together a nice report and email summarizing what we did. But what if we could help that process out and have a column that has a nice description of what the item is, the blockers, and a copy and paste format that we can take and put directly in our email? Well, that's another great use case for a prompt column. So let's add another new column here. I'll call this the summary column. We'll click on our data type and choose prompt again. And we'll add a new prompt. We'll remove what's in there, and then I'll paste in this prompt that I have. So what I'm going to ask this to do is, based on the task update, take the details, the completion percentage, who did it, and any blockers, and generate a status update for stakeholders that includes current progress, any risk, estimated completion date, and required support. So again, I need to point to data from my table. So I'm going to start replacing some of these placeholder values I have. So we have task details. One trick you can do there is you can do a forward slash, and that will open up this knowledge window for you. And we'll map that to task details. Click add. We'll do the same thing for completion percentage, and the same thing again for team member. And lastly, for the blockers that we have. Okay, so that's the prompt. We're giving it more inputs this time and asking it to actually create new text for us. So let's see how it does. We'll run another test. And this right here is looking pretty good. We have our risk and blockers section, estimated completion, required support, everything that I asked it for. And when you're testing your prompt columns, you can not only see the model response, but if you click knowledge used, you can see where it got all those details and which specific data points that it pulled from to get that information. And depending on what you're doing in your prompt, you also have the ability to change the model that it's using. The default is GPT 4.1 mini, but if you click on this dropdown next to model, we can change that to 4.1, even 03, or we can even bring in our own model with AI Foundry. So let's save this now. So we saved our prompt, and then we're going to save the column itself. And we'll run through another test here and see what it generates for us in this prompt column when I add a new project update. Now for this one, let's see what it looks like in a model-driven app rather than just updating the table directly. We have our model-driven app pulled up. I'll add a new project task. So I put in some details about what I've done, some blockers. We'll choose a date for this. I'll put in my completion percentage and of course my name, and we'll click save. And you'll notice right as I saved it, that summary field is populated for us. It made all those sections that I asked for as far as the progress, the task details, blockers, and the completion date and required support. I can take this, copy and paste it in an email, and not have to duplicate any work. Now that in a nutshell is how AI prompts work, but I can't let you go without talking about licensing because I know that question always comes up. Now this is using Dataverse, so first and foremost, that means you will need Power Apps Premium licensing. Second of all, it is using AI Builder, so that means you need appropriate credits to be able to use these prompts. Now, Power Apps Premium licensing does come with some AI Builder credits for you, I believe 500. So you do have that at your disposal, so you'd have to kind of keep in mind how many credits an individual prompt is going to use and how many items you anticipate are going to be added into your database per month and do the math there. And I'll put a link in the description below where you can see some more details about exactly how these work licensing-wise and what you need and what credits and everything that you get based off of the licenses that you have. And of course, as always, I would love to know what you think about this new feature. Is it useful for you? Do you have any cool use cases? Do you have any feedback to make it better? Drop a note in the comments and let me know. Thank you so much for watching. Do me a big favor if you found this video helpful. Click on that subscribe button to support the channel and be alerted for more videos. Thanks, and I'll see you in the next video.